Hi guys, it's Alice, and today I'm going to recommend some Scandinavian fiction for you. Now, this is kind of a highly requested video, which is really fun, and I'm excited to do it, but when I started looking into books to mention for this video, I realized how little Scandinavian fiction I actually read and have read. I think I was about 16 or 17 when I started to read books in English, and it slowly progressed to becoming only in English. And the Norwegian books that I did read were usually translated from English. So I actually haven't read that many Scandinavian books since, I don't know, like 10 years ago or something. And I don't really read Scandinavian books in English because that doesn't make a whole lot of sense. So I haven't read that much in like ages. So I've gathered up some recommendations for books I remember loving, but just bear in mind that I did read some of these quite some time ago. I actually feel like I really need to up my Scandinavian fiction game, and I would love to reread some of these books, or maybe do like a whole Scandi fiction project. Would that be something you guys would be interested in? Or maybe we should do like a readathon. That would be really fun. I also obviously read all of these books in Norwegian, and I only included books that I could find an English translation of. And I will link both the Norwegian and the English editions in the description. You can also check the description box if I say a name in Norwegian and you can't understand what I'm saying. Oh, another thing before we start, and I don't really know if I need to clarify this, and this is like the longest intro ever, but I made a video about Scandinavian films, like 2 years ago or something, and in that video people seemed a little confused as to what countries are actually in Scandinavia. And at least here in Norway, it refers to Norway, Sweden, and Denmark. And then if someone refers to the Nordic countries, that includes Iceland and Finland. So in this video, all the authors are going to be either Norwegian, Swedish, or Danish. I'm going to start with a book that I read when I was the youngest and then work my way up until this year. And the first book I want to mention is Isslottet by Tarjei Vesaas. The English title of this is The Ice Palace. The author is Norwegian, and this is like a modern classic. And the story is about two young girls who become friends, but then when one of them goes missing, the other one's world is shattered. It's a book dealing with friendship and grief, and it features a magnificent ice palace. And I still remember what I imagined that to look like in my head. And I think I was about 12, maybe, when I read this, and it made a really strong impression on me. And I had like a book hangover for weeks afterwards. It is a little weird, but I remember just loving it. I've seen an English edition of this in the Penguin Modern Classic Editions, and that cover is beautiful. And I would love to get it, but it doesn't really make that much sense to me, seeing as if I was going to reread it, I would probably do so in Norwegian. Next up, we have the Millennium Trilogy by Stieg Larsson. Larsson is Swedish, and this trilogy consists of Män som hatar kvinnor, which translates to Men Who Hate Women, but in English it has gotten the title The Girl with the Dragon Tattoo. The second book is Jenta som lekte med ilden, which translates to The Girl Who Played with Fire. And the last book is Luftslottet som sprenges, which I guess means the air palace that blew up, but in English it has gotten the title The Girl Who Kicked the Hornet's Nest. This is a best-selling trilogy, and it's immensely popular here in Norway. It follows a young woman who is incredibly intelligent, and she's a brilliant hacker, but she has really poor social skills. And then we also follow an investigative journalist, and they sort of team up to solve this 40-year-old disappearance. I remember being completely sucked into these books, and not only is the mystery really intriguing and the atmosphere is amazing, but I had never really read about a female character like the main character in this book. I actually really want to reread these, and I feel like it's been like just long enough now for me to have forgotten a lot of it. Now, this was initially supposed to be like a 10-book series, but the author sadly passed away before he could finish them, and I think another author has like continued on with the series, so there are more books, but I just haven't read any of them. I can also recommend watching the Swedish movie adaptations of these books, although be warned, there are some really brutal scenes in them. And they are in the book too, but sometimes it's a little bit different to actually see it visually. I've also seen the American adaptation, and please just watch the Swedish ones, because they are way better. Then I've got another series, and it is the Kurt Wallander series by Henning Mankell. This author is also Swedish, and he wrote a lot of books, but he is perhaps most famous for his series Following the Detective Kurt Wallander. And I think there are about 10 books in the series. And the thing is, I'm pretty sure I read most of them, but not all of them. And I don't really remember which ones I read because I didn't read them in order. But as far as I can remember, my favorites were the first one, which is called Mordere uten ansikt, which translates to Faceless Killers. And then the third one, Den hvite løvinnen, which in English is called The White Lioness. Both my mother and my grandfather loved this author, and I remember they got really excited every time a new book came out. And I think I ended up reading them just because they were so excited about those books and I just wanted to know what the fuss was about. I don't really remember any of them very clearly, but I do remember loving the mysteries, and I was really intrigued by the detective, and I loved talking about those books with my grandfather when I saw him and stuff like that. This author also, like I mentioned, wrote a lot of other books, and I know that I did read quite a lot of them too, but I don't remember which was which, so I really should reread those as well. Then we have got yet another series by yet another Swedish author, although he is also half French, I think. And this trilogy is called Two Different Things in English, so it's either the Knight Templar trilogy or the Crusades trilogy by Jan Guillou. This trilogy consists of Vayen til Jerusalem, meaning the road to Jerusalem, Tempelridderen, meaning the Knight Templar, and Rike ved Vayens Ende, meaning the kingdom at the end of the road. But I've also seen editions of the third book that are called Birth of the Kingdom, so I don't really know what's up with that. There's also like a fourth book that's like a part of this, but also like a standalone called Arven etter Arn, which means the inheritance after Arn. And I couldn't find an English translation of this, so I don't know if it's been translated. And I also haven't actually read it, so I don't really know why I'm mentioning it. These books are historical fiction, and we follow a boy who is born in 1150. And I really don't want to tell you too much about the storyline because it's really fun to discover for yourself, but in parts of the first book, we see this young boy grow up and live at this monastery and get his education there, and when he's 17, he returns home. And he meets these two sisters who complicate his life very much, and the ball starts rolling. Now that I'm talking about these, I'm 100% sure I'm going to reread these because I remember being so into these books. Like, I could not stop reading because it was so exciting and I loved the characters and the setting. And although I'm aware that it's like 6 years ago since I read these and I may be remembering them a little better than they actually were, I think maybe they're the best historical fiction books I've ever read. Then we're moving on to more standalone novels, although the first one is technically a part of a series, but I haven't had the best of luck with all the books in that series, so I'm just gonna recommend the one I like the most, plus another one by the same author, and it is Snømann and Hodejegerne by Jo Nesbø. Nesbø is probably Norway's most famous author, and I used to read almost all of his books, but at some point I read like two in a row that I really didn't like, and I just sort of decided to put him down for a while, and now it's been like 6 years. So Snømann translates to The Snowman, and it's a part of the Harry Hole series. But I never read these books in order, so I'm pretty sure it's okay to just read them out of order and pick up the ones that you want. This one is set in November in Oslo, and the detective in this one stumbles upon what he thinks is a serial killer. And this one is so suspenseful, and I loved the mystery, and it's really dark, and I was just glued to the pages for the ending of this one. Hodejegerne translates to Headhunters, and this is a standalone novel about this corporate headhunter who steals art on the side, and then one day he meets a man who he decides to steal something from, and doing that has terrible, terrible consequences, and it's very, very exciting. The last three books I have are all books that I've read while I've had this channel, so you may have heard me mention them before. And the first one is actually the only Danish author I've got in this video, and it is Vi de Druknede by Carsten Jensen. This translates to We the Drowned, and it's a historical fiction novel that starts off in 1848, and we follow the sailors of this little Danish island, and we follow them through four generations all over the world and through two world wars. Some parts of this are a little bit slow, but I still think this is a wonderful book. I loved the characters in it, the writing is lovely, and I sometimes find with like generational novels that there's always like one character that you're not as intrigued by, but that wasn't the case of this at all because I loved all of them. Second to last, we've got a book that I've mentioned so much that I'm sure you're tired of hearing about it, but here it is again, and it is Størst av alt by Malin Persson Giolito. Giolito is Swedish, and this was one of my favorite books that I read last year. The English title of this is Quicksand, and it's set in a wealthy suburb in Stockholm, and we follow this young girl who has been charged with her involvement in a school shooting that left many of her classmates dead, including her best friend and her boyfriend. We really get deep into the head of the main character in this book, and she is kind of difficult to figure out. Sometimes you really sympathize with her, sometimes you hate her, but slowly throughout the book, both her character and the story is revealed. I also love how this book comments on what it's like to be young and grow up in a Swedish society, because it reminds me very much of what it's like to grow up in Norway, so that resonated very deeply with me. Lastly, we've got a book that I read this year, and it is Bienes Historia by Maja Lunde. Lunde is Norwegian, and the English title of this is The History of Bees, and the story follows three different characters in three different time periods. So we have got a man living in 1852, and he has just invented a new beehive. We follow a man in the US who is a beekeeper in 2007, and then we follow a woman in China in 2098. Who works with hand-pollinating flowers because all of the bees on Earth have died. This is a commentary on our current climate and what we're doing to the Earth, and I thought that was really interesting. I did think when I read this that it was a little bit slow in parts, but I have thought a lot about this book since I read it, and I remember all the characters, and I like still keep coming back to them, which is how I know that I really like a book. This is also the first book in a quartet, and I think the second book is already out, and the third one is coming out this fall, and I really need to read those. Okay guys, those were all the recommendations that I had for you today. I'd love to know if you've read any of these books, or if you want to, or what your favorite Scandinavian book is, and I will see you soon. Bye!